you gon' ever hurt or injure mine. He have your woman, and that's my dinner time. I keep my eyes on glory, tell the devil get behind. Now bear in mind, the devil made me offers I decline. We not aligned, not combined, I am not confined to any wicked system that these demons have designed. They frame a mind and have you salty as a bacon rind. I'm trying to mastermind how to help out humankind. I'm open mind, but I do not rock with none aligned. My state of mind is to keep a peace with peace of mind. I'm like Malcolm with my peace at the Venetian blinds. I'm trying to manifest some things in my subconscious mind that I have only seen in dreams in my unconscious mind. My dreams unrefined, spring to mind, a state of mind that make it seem this lucky life of mine is pre-designed. And if it is, then thank the Lord, cause that's the mastermind. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four-door Audi when it smoked, make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I buy it, I ain't bragging. I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came on them. I do my own stunts, don't need a backup. Tired of feeling broke, I got my racks up. These four pockets full won't fold on me. How you claim me, you my scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number one. I was walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four-door Audi. When it smoke, they get the hot and make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number one.
Motion is breaking news, they got an ad on TV. Popping out all of my politics and probably in a section where you're not permitted. My honey's matching my Dodger fitted, playing all gold, ain't no stopping in it. Look, salute when you see me. I bought her a CC and that was her purse. Disgusting what do for a purse, disgusting what do for the clout. I'm one of the realest, the realest could vouch. They thought I was done, but all that doubt, you gotta pay money, mess around. Salute when you see me. Put in the car to the my runner get to you speedy. Still thugging like the days when they weren't hearing my CD. Made it out of the trenches. Yeah, salute when you see me. Yeah, salute when you see me. I'm getting greedy, I blow the whole budget on me. That's on me, I'm conceited. Treaty, nah, that ain't how we treat it. This right here sound like a three-peat. I put the dip in, it sound like I'm knee-deep. I'm like, oh, you too needy. Me and HB going Juvie and BG. They gotta put my face on the box of Wheaties. I'm praying for whoever think they compete. Salute when you see me. That's all he ever, so that's how you greet me. I'm going TM-101, cheesy, and plus they got D2 on repeat. I'm with the love of my life in like 3 weeks, cause that's all I needed. She wanna go on a trip or retreat, but I'm sorry I never retreated. I set the bar so high that you might as well leave it. I'm going undefeated. I've broken the system, had to breach it. That's mission impossible, mission completed. Salute when you see me.
Yeah. I got the heart of a god and a genie. I want you to love me, I want you to need me. When I this face and feed it. I gotta get back to the hood. I remember when I was the needy. Clean me up, squeaky. She fell in love, deeply. Sleepy, they like what I say, they repeat me. All this money I be spending on BBs. That's why you gotta salute when you see me.
Met her on the beach, so it's not nice.
Oh no, oh man, I just made a mess. When I run it, ain't no stopping, oh, never rest. Down said hunt, kick a punt, then I make a catch. 5,000 ones in an hour, I'ma make it stretch. I just made a mess, I just made a mess. I got cash by the bundle, so I never press. I just made a mess, I just made a mess. 50-yard TD, we do winning catch. Oh no, oh no.
Something we've only seen less than a handful of times since this franchise was born back in the 90s, and that's Jacksonville hosting in the playoffs as we welcome you to TIAA Bank Field. Straight ahead, it's Wild Card Weekend, and we've got a great one in store between the New England Patriots and the Jacksonville Jaguars. The Lamar Hunt Trophy begins as we're underway in this AFC wildcard game. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
The guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
On second and nine, Jones. He finds Smith out of the backfield. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44.
Well, this is an awfully tough route to defend in man coverage because he lines up on the right and runs a crossing route back to the other side of the field. So as a defender, you're not only trailing him the whole way, you're also looking out for your own guys to make sure you don't get yourself picked off. And then you can't catch up in time to prevent the completion.
First carry for Damian Harris, the Alabama man. Absolutely nobody fooled there. He's going nowhere fast as he stopped behind the line of scrimmage. So the first down run lost a couple. Now they come up second and 12. On the give, this is Harris. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. They'll get four on second down, but it leaves them with third and still nine to go.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
He'll find his man, Terrace Marshall, complete. And he will have a Patriots first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
So in Jacksonville territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 39-yard line.
Man, I know I'm tapping this damn button over here.
And that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves him back five. So a little bit of a stiffer challenge now, first and 15 following the delay of game.
Holy God,
blah. Yardage here, back at the 47. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down. Jones. The ball popped in the air and intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker Miles Jack. And the Jaguars are going to get possession here as they force the opening drive turnover. And certainly, look, you're on the road in the playoffs. That is a suboptimal start, opening drive INT.
And partner, sometimes I wonder, do these teams talk about it to such an extent that maybe you almost talk yourself into the turnover when you're trying to avoid it?
Yeah, maybe they get a little too worried about keeping the football, and then you give it to the other team right off the bat. And look, we said it, on the road, this is just a terrible, terrible start for them.
It is, and now they've got to rely on their defense.
They try to run on first down, but this defense says no dice. They stop them a couple yards behind the line of scrimmage.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef, they want to run the football. But that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result, negative yardage. So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. Now Lawrence. And connecting here with DJ Shark. Well, he gets this deep into Patriot territory. It's a big play for the Jaguars. That was so well timed. Just a perfect throw on the slam.
Hit him on the move, didn't he?
Yeah,
now he's going against the grain of the defenders coming over to try and stop him. That allowed for that additional yardage downfield.
On first down, Lawrence being chased out left. And he's just going to throw this one out of bounds here. Nowhere to go with it. Incomplete.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
Kill, kill, kill. Hey, lock it.
On second down, it's Taylor. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. He lost two there, and it's third down.
That was a terrific play, causing a loss. As a middle linebacker, simple. You can either fill holes, or you can attack them, as he did there.
An extra corner comes on now for the Patriots D on third down. Looking to throw, Lawrence. Eluding the pressure right. Give him 8 yards that time on the scramble, and now fourth down.
Well, Gardner, nothing comes open here, so he decides to escape out of there, and he doesn't pick up a first down, but he does gain additional yardage to set up a possible field goal attempt if they decide to go that route.
The kick by Lambeau is good. Every possession in the postseason magnified, and look, it's just the opening drive. They didn't get the touchdown they wanted, but at least they got on the board.
They got on the board. They've got their home crowd into it as well. And remember, in the playoffs, the game slows down a little bit, so every point is precious.
Now after the main field goal, back out Lambeau to kick this one off. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Pats at the line, ready to go. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, only gave up 3 points off of that, so it shouldn't be a difficult hole to overcome.
It really shouldn't, as long as they're not listening to the chatter coming from the other side, because when you throw a pick, look, I know defensive backs, they have a tendency to be a little bit loud. After
come on, Nelson.
Away. But they also have a tendency to gamble a little bit more, thinking they'll get a second one. Maybe they can take advantage of that with some double moves.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Now a give, running left is Harris. And some good tackling there as he stopped up at about the 41. Give him a carry there, second and 8.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going, and then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
The last run good for 2. Here's second and 8. Gets it quickly out to Marshall. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34. 3-0 after 1 on EA Sports. Trying to pick it up on the ground with Harris. And Harris is not going to get there. Defensively to stop him short. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave him with a fourth down. The Patriots will bring on the field goal unit. On the left hash, officially it's called a 51-yard attempt. This one is right through, and that will tie us at 3-3. Maybe a little fortunate there. That was leaking a little, maybe leaking a lot, but he got it.
Yeah, he actually was able to make it work. How about the body language, though, right? As he watched that ball leak to the right, trying to bring it back in, and had just enough to get it done.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it. Forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right?
Oh, my God.
That's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put 6 on the board. That's a consolation prize, like going to the county fair. You don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material. Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here, second and a yard from the 34. From the gun, it's Taylor. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line.
Randy, you know that expression? He just does what he does. It sounds trite, doesn't it? But in this case, it's perfectly apt. This is one of the better runners in the NFL. And all he does is just find avenues, find ways to pick up key first downs and big runs.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. They go play action with Lawrence. That one complete. He finds Shark. And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards. Second down and 3. Out of the gun, it's Lawrence. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. A big play that time on the catch and run.
Of course, the catch was nice, but how about what happened after? Able to stay on his feet and gain all that additional yardage. So many of these slot guys, I think, have running back in their background.
Go, go. Kill, kill, kill. Turn it.
On first and 10, it's Lawrence. They'll set up the screen to Taylor. That's a room to run now. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10.
And that was a beautifully executed screen pass. They let the rushers get upfield and get the escorts in front, meaning the offensive linemen, other blockers out in front. Completed the pass beautifully. So now you've got all that open space with big guys leading the way.
Man, what kind of...
Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. They had to settle for 3 last drive, hoping this second go-around ends in 6. In good position, first and 10. From the gun, it's Lawrence. Flushed out right.
Oh, come on, bro.
Touchdown, Jaguars.
What the fuck, my quarterback spied.
A 12-yard touchdown grab. And the Jaguars have taken the lead.
Good play.
Those are the touchdowns that are just scored on Sundays or on Monday night. Those are the ones that are scored during the week because they had that preparation and a great route run.
Oh, I love that observation because you don't just roll out on game day and say, okay, go run this route and just get it done. That means exactly what you said. The practice had to occur beforehand, which led to the timing, which led to the touchdown.
Off too loud.
And Lambeau now after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. And that'll be a little too hot to handle as it will skip through the end zone for a touchback here. At the line, ready to go. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. Mm-hmm. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they've got to make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put 6 on the board here. We'll see. Here's second and 10. Let's go, is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11. First down as they're able to get the third down conversion. So he turned to a trusted, familiar face in that third down situation. It paid off.
Yeah, you go to your veteran receiver in that spot, so you can't underestimate him when he's on the field defensively. Make sure you know where he is, because he understands how to get open in key situations.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9. 2 minutes to play here in this first half of the NFL playoffs.
Okay.
Coming up at the half, we remind you that we're going to do what we've done all year. We'll get you down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. Coach will have the lowdown on what's going on here in this wild card weekend as we begin the road to the upcoming Super Bowl. Second and 9. Jones. The connection here with Nelson Aguilar. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars 43.
We didn't need to ask around the league, but we got to confirm this guy's a good player. They've got to find a way to get him more involved. Call a few more plays that target him.
Absolutely, because here we are toward the end of the first half, and that's the first target, not just the first catch, first target. Now a play fake here on first down. He's going to loft one deep over the middle. And it is incomplete. Good positioning there downfield to break that one up. Well, the incompletion, yes, but maybe here not the worst thing in the world?
No, not on first and 10. Actually gives them a chance to regroup, relax just a little bit. They huddle up, talk it over. Then they get a chance to continue their drive.
Second and 10. Try the left side. Harris. They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4.
Good running right there. And this is a man who's a 1,000-yard rusher in the regular season, so you know he's going to get his chances. And he picks up nice yardage on that one.
Here's the 7th play of this drive. This is 3rd and 4. Looking to throw. Jones. Complete. Hunter hits the completion now lines up a launch, and it'll bring up 4th down. The Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number 1.
Oh, fuck.
And that is.
Damn.
But he couldn't work it back in.
Motherfucker.
These playoff games have a tendency to be tight. You have to wonder if that missed field goal could
Yeah, we're always looking for the key plays, right? The ones that we're going to magnify. Usually those happen in the second half or later in the game. This might be the key play of the game showing up here in the first half.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And with great starting field position and a couple of timeouts at their disposal, they'll certainly have the green light here.
Man, go get my shit, boy.
Complete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Fuck. That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them, and I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
Off the play fake. Here's Lawrence.
Get it out of his hand. Come on, Ty. Fuck.
Now the Jags will use the 2nd of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 33 seconds to go in the first half. From the 32 now, here's 1st and 10. Play action. It's Lawrence. escaping the pressure. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. The Jaguars now will use the last of their timeouts as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in the first half of play. So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often. Second and 24. They go play action now. Lawrence, and he'll let this one go deep for Chark.
Bro, I don't understand that shit, bro. That's fucking crazy just now.
Touchdown had something that was kind of rooted in that.
Why Tyler Lawrence on him in the first place?
They had a plan. Let's find a way.
Come on,
bro. Right here before the half, and that'll give us momentum going into the second half. Give us that cushion that we're looking for.
Yeah.
They got that accomplished, scoring right before the half ended.
Extra point tacked on by Lambo. And the lead is now 17-3. One away. And that one bounces out of the back of the end zone, so we'll start the drive at the 25 on the touchback. At the line, ready to go. And we'll see how they want to play this. Just a little over 20 seconds to go. On first and 10, Jones. And that is incomplete. So 17 seconds now on the clock here.
The touch of time here critical for those types of throws. He put a lot of zip on that one. Needed just a little bit more finesse trying to get it to his back.
Throw again on second down. Jones taking a shot here for Marshall. And I think that one might have been intercepted, but he will be ruled out of bounds. So this will go only as incomplete.
Certainly no lack of aggressiveness here. They were hoping for the home run play to get them 6 points. They're hoping for a catch, maybe a call. But they figure they can at least get into field goal range with a completion.
And he's going to be stopped here a few yards short of the first as the tackle is made at the 33. So we're at halftime. It's an NFC wild card matchup. As we send you a couple hours south of here to Orlando, that's where we check in with a coach and our EA Sports halftime report. Both teams try to avoid being one and done in these playoffs as we start the second half of this AFC wild card game. Now Jamal Agnew from his end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. And they're in the position they expected to be in. They've got the lead, home crowd behind them, and they're looking toward making that next step in these playoffs.
And I think a key for them is to put together some good, long, extended drives. Work the run in a little more with that big offensive line.
I'm not saying get away from throwing the football. That's still working. But if they run it more effectively, they may get even bigger plays in the passing game.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about. And you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent, and that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
On second down now, it's Taylor, and not much there. Maybe a yard up to the 24.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down, then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in the expected passing situation.
Lawrence, and they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
Snap to Lawrence as he taps this forward. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. From the shotgun, Lawrence. And this will be swung out wide for Taylor. Got this to the 30 before being taken down. A big play there on the catch and run.
A lot of times the key is just get him the ball and let him do his thing, and they got it out to him on the left side, and he did exactly that. Excellent run after the catch.
First and 10, Taylor now. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about 4 to go.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
Here's the 7th play of this drive. This is 3rd and 4.
52 is the mark, boys. 52.
Hey, Alpha. Come on, boy. Christian, grab it. Don't be scared.
Check 52 is the mark. Check 52.
Now Lawrence. He's to the 10. Open man is Taylor. He's got it. Touchdown. A 24-yard touchdown. And the Jaguars continue to show why it pays to play at home in the postseason as they add on to their lead. Point after by Limbaugh, up and good. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. And Limbaugh now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. And this will be a touchback. Berrios deciding not to bring it out. At the line, ready to go. They're down 3 touchdowns to this point, needing to put something together as they have it 1st and 10. And he'll wind up with about 6 up past the 30 to the 31.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least two first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
Second and four. Back to throw. Jones. Going to Woods, but that pass is intercepted. Picked off at the 47. This defense, Charles, coming up with another interception. They have really done an excellent job of locking up these receivers.
Yeah, they're really on fire. They are actually doing what they talk about all the time, which is plastering to receivers when they're in their zones. They didn't give up a touchdown in the first half. Haven't done so here in this half either. Blanketed the field, going all the way back to the opening drive, and they come up with a pick right there.
So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material. Now Lawrence to throw. Flush to his right. And he wisely will throw that one away. Not his best throw there, but where we sit right now in the third quarter, he's had a pretty good game throwing the football.
He certainly has, and it's not exactly at the point where we're doing four-minute offense yet, but they've got to think about, I'm not going to say milking the clock, but understanding clock management here on out.
To throw once more on second and 10. Lawrence got a man and he hits him in stride. And he's taken down inside the 30.
And while we may be looking at the scoreboard, this offense certainly is not, because they're showing no signs of backing down. Lead here in the third quarter. I think they keep taking their shots. They've seen blown leads happen throughout this league. They don't want to fall victim to it themselves.
Throwing now, Lawrence on first down, eluding the pressure right. Stopped at the 24-yard line after a gain of 5.
They brought the blitz that time, and I thought they were going to get to him, but instead, he flipped it on its ear and ended up picking up positive yardage.
I thought he was dead to rights, but you are exactly correct, sir. Able to turn that into a positive gain. On second down, a run with ETN. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage.
Well, that kind of hit will certainly fire up your team, both on the field and on the sideline. Tackles for lost yardage, they're always welcome.
On third down, Lawrence. He'll get this out to the flat for ETN. And he will have a Jaguars first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. One quarter remains for the right to survive round one here in the AFC. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. Running out of the gun with ETN. And a short pickup there down to about the 9. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
They're in a pretty good spot right now with a convincing lead. I think this is where they put on the boxing gloves, start to try and pound them into submission.
And the offensive line, they've controlled this game. I don't see why that trend would change now. Still 9 remaining on second down.
46 to Mike, 46.
Hey, Echo. Hey, check Mike 46. Check Mike 46.
Here's Lawrence. And that is caught. Touchdown, Jacksonville. Tyler Conklin there to make the grab. And the Jaguars are able to widen their lead. Well, look, this is a team, Charles. They faced adversity all year long. They had a fight and claw to win that division, but they're putting it all together here in the wild card game.
Feels like a statement, doesn't it? An absolute statement game. A message to the top seeds. Overlook us at your own peril. We're pretty darn good.
Extra point tacked on by Lambeau, and that'll increase their lead to 28. And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Pats at the line, ready to go. They are most likely staring at a cold end to their season here in this wild card round. Nothing has gone right so far, and they are, to be frank, in desperation mode now as they begin with a first and 10. Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. They'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31. You got the big lead defensively, willing to give them that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle them after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
Here's a pass swung out left to his running back. And he'll be brought down right around the 37.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone.
My first thought is surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
On second and 10, Jones, and he drops it incomplete. And their struggles continue here. Well, it just seems like all game long, there hasn't been a lot of sync quarterback to wide receiver on this side of the football.
They haven't been on the same page, quarterback and receivers. Heck, they haven't been on the same grease board when you draw plays up. They haven't been on the same surface tablet that you look at on the sidelines. Nothing's worked for them. They've got to find a way to start matching each other's movements.
Again, he'll drop to throw. And that is incomplete.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
Fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out.
Okay, just like that. Just like that.
Gotta try it here. He's back to throw. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert. And they turn it over. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Jags take over in terrific field position. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Here's a give to ETN. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. Here's Lawrence to throw. Flushed out right. And Lawrence going to smartly hit the deck here as he is able to pick up the first down in the process.
Now, that was a whole lot of open space out in front of him, wasn't it? I'm telling you, Brandon, when things are going right, they are going right.
And everything has been going their way for the most part. I saw that lane start to develop. Boom, he took advantage of it.
Watch the run. Where's
Now Lawrence on first down. He's going to let it go deep for the end zone. Well, that ball is caught by DJ Chark for the Jags touchdown. DJ Chark, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Jaguars continue to roll. Lambeau to add on the extra point. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. Fielded just outside the goal line. And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line. The Pats at the line, ready to go. And at this point, maybe you say, you know, it was a good effort, really, just to make the playoffs. They couldn't win their division, but did earn a wild card berth. Oh, Jones has just thrown his third interception. Shaquille Griffin with a pick. CD, this defense here. At this rate, they're just having fun out there right now.
And normally, with this type of a lead, if you're a starter on defense, you're saying, hey, let the other guys play. But with this going on, no one wants to come out of the game. They all want their shot at picking off a pass.
On first down, Taylor. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
Now this one to his tight end out on the right side and brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. And looking to put this game on ice in the fourth quarter, but still not afraid to throw it, as they show there.
You want to play the game with confidence, and they have a guy who's in control right now. Their trigger guy throwing it, they feel just as confident with him doing that as they would if they tried to run the ball and run the clock out.
They'll run on first down. Taylor. Well, they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the 2. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Jaguar football here as we welcome you back. They've got it first and goal in a game that appears to have already been decided. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. Now, CD, there didn't seem to be much resistance there down near the goal line.
Yeah, partner, from what I saw there, not a real good job of matching up defensively, because to me, it looked like they were just in their base 3-4 package. You need bigger bodies in there in a goal line type situation. The 3-4 fine between the 20s, not down here when you're guarding your end zone.
Now after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. This taken in at the goal line and out a little across the 25 to the 27. At the line, ready to go. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
that's all that's left, because victory, not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it, because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys on the field now, and if they call plays they want executed, they need to do that and do it really well. Otherwise, there could be repercussions.
We'll see how they handle the waning moments of this one. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd and 7.
Yo, Bo's the mic. Mike's Bo. I'm here all day.
They'll keep it on the ground. Harris again. Trying to bounce it outside, but he's only able to get it back to the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down. They run the counter. It's Harris. Well, this is going to depend on the spot. It's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. It's complete, left side to Aguilar. But they're going to wrap him up as he'll go down well short of a first. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and the Jags take over in terrific field position. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Looks like he'll throw here. He lost 9 there. That's really going to set him back for second down. And I know it's hard to find solace on one side when the season ends, no matter where it ends, but especially in the playoffs, because there's all that build-up to the moment. But I would imagine the post-game locker room speech, it'll have a pretty positive spin.
It should. They made a heck of a run to get to the playoffs and have that chance to advance, even though they didn't. But you're right about how much it's going to hurt, because when you work that hard to get this far, it hurts just a little bit more. No matter when your season ends, it's a downer. But in this case, even more so, because you had your eyes on the big prize, which was the Lombardi Trophy.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. The Jaguars are winners here as we say so long from Jacksonville.